Hi there, welcome on Travels and Code channel. Today I will show you how to use UiPath 2020, how to install it, connect to Orchestrator, create the first robot and deploy this robot to Orchestrator. After that I will show you how to configure UiPath Assistant to run this robot using Orchestrator and Assistant. And in the end we will have finished infrastructure. Also, I would recommend you to subscribe my channel in the end, or you can do it right now. So, let's start from installation UiPath Studio 2020. UiPath is one of the top robotic process automation tools, and to use it we need Windows, because of it's created specifically for Windows, and if you have Linux or macOS, you need to use a virtual machine. I have a separate video how to install virtual machine to macOS. So, in this video we will start from installation UiPath Studio. The first what you need to go to uipath.com, official website, and let's click try UiPath free. What's interesting that the UiPath has free community edition version and we can use it the whole time. So, the first what we need to sign up. Let's sign up with email. The next you need to choose your country. For me it's Ukraine, but I don't have Ukraine in this list. I will show you what to do in this case. If your country isn't in this list, it means that you cannot use UiPath. But we can handle this problem, so let's choose United States and continue. Then we need email, then we click confirm terms of use and let's sign up. After that we need to verify our email, so you can go to your email and verify it. After that, when you verify the email, I already verified it, we can click here and let's sign in. So right now we are on cloud of UiPath, so here we see that we have Orchestrator service already created for us, and what's important, we can download Studio. So let's click download Studio, and what we will see, we have 403 error, it's forbidden. We have this error because of we are right now from Ukraine and this country isn't in a list of allowed countries. So to fix this problem we need to install VPN and download this Studio through the VPN. So let's go to I'm using this one VPN. The free version will be enough for us. So let's install this VPN. 500 megabytes is okay. So this tunnel bear VPN was installed. Let's open it and was downloaded. And let's install this VPN. In your case, you can use any other VPN. So let's install this one. If you are from another country where installation is allowed, you can skip this part and go to the next section where we will install UiPath Studio directly. Also, we need to create free account, so use the same email. I will use the same. After that, we need to verify this email as well. So I verified my email, let's click OK. And now we need to choose United States. Let's choose United States and wait for a while. Okay, we are connected in United States. So let's go again to UiPath Studio, to the cloud and click download Studio. So we see this size, it's okay for us, save file, and now as you see we can install UiPath Studio without any problems. Okay, while we installing UiPath Studio I will show you Orchestrator how to connect it. When we were signed up to UiPath we are on cloud platform, or you can click just platform go to this URL and it will be redirected to cloud. Let's go to services and we see that we have one enabled service. It's our orchestrator. Let's click it. And now we are in orchestrator. We don't need to create any other orchestrator. We do not need to install it separately. It's specifically, it's just a web application, which we will use. Okay, UiPath Studio was downloaded. Let's go to downloads. What's important, I didn't mention that we have Windows 10 operating system. It's just installed out of the box without installing any other packages or libraries. I didn't install C++ language, so we can use this operating system from the box. Let's click UiPath Studio Setup. So we are using UiPath 2020, it's a beta, not final version, so there might be some issues. Okay, on the home screen, we need to use community license, because of we will use community version. And we don't want to pay for a license. Then we need, we will use Studio Pro community. Okay, let's use stable version. Also, then we need to choose source control support. We will use Git, we can use, but this one we can skip. Let's click continue. And we have installed UiPath Studio. Let's create a first robot. Go to process. Okay, we don't need VPN anymore, so we can, it was already turned off, so let's turn off VPN. So we have UiPath Studio main screen. Let's go to main workflow and create first activity. Let's click plus and we need message box. Add a quoted text. So we created the first text. Yes, I will subscribe to Travels and Code channel. After that, we can debug this robot. And we see this message box, it was executed, it works. Okay, and now we need to connect this robot to orchestrator and then run this robot without UiPath Studio. So how we can do it? Let's go to UiPath orchestrator, then we need to go machines and we need to create a first machine. It will be connected to this one we are using for creating robots. Let's add a new machine. We will use standard one, not floating. Name. We will use the same name we have on our computer. Let's open system tray and open UiPath Assistant. Right now it's offline. Let's go to settings and orchestrator settings. On this screen we see machine name. Let's copy this name. Added here. Then we need the license unattended robots. Let's increase to 1 and testing environments 1 as well. Let's click provision. Okay, we created a first robot, and now we see that we can copy key. So, and we can click this one, we will copy machine key. The next one, in settings, we can add this robot. So, machine key we need put into this field, and we need orchestrator URL. How we can get this URL? Let's go to orchestrator again, and we need copy URL till the default word. So this section. Again, copy it and put here as well. And now we can try to connect. So we see that it was connected, but it was unlicensed. Okay, and how work is done? Let's now create, let's go to robots in orchestrator and create our first robot. And it will be a standard robot as well. And now we can choose machine. Machine is our computer. Then we need the name of this robot. It will be our Hello World. Description we can skip. Type. Let's try unattended. We will use orchestrator database, and we need to use. We need put domain and username. How we can get this data? Let's go to our computer. Put cmd command prompt, and here we will type who am I, and we get this data. Let's copy and put here. Then we need put the password. It's your Microsoft Windows password, which you are using to sign in. So let's check this password. Yes. Let's click create. The next, let's go to UiPath Studio and let's publish this robot. Version will be 1.01. Let's click publish. We don't need any other options. So we see that project was successfully published. Let's click OK and go to orchestrator again. And we see that this robot is available. The next, what we need to do, let's go to okay, let's open UiPath settings, UiPath Assistant, and we see that this is connected and licensed already. So it's what we expected. And now we can close this setting window and open UiPath Assistant. Right now we see that there is nothing. Okay, let's create a new process. No, the first one, what we need create environment. Let's go to robots. Let's go to environment and create new environment. Let's call it demo. Create this environment, and we need add our first robot to this environment. So it will be Hello World. Great. Update, and now we can go to processes. Let's create new process. We need to choose prod package. It's Hello World package we already published to orchestrator. Version the latest one, environment demo. Then we will have priority normal, it doesn't matter, and that's it. Let's click create. And now we see this button. We can start a job. Let's try to click what we will see. So we see that we have process and we have this robot. We can choose robot. We can choose this robot on this window just because we choose unattended robot. So for UiPath, there are two types of robots, attendant and unattended. If we are using attendant type of robot, we cannot run it using UiPath Studio. But for unattended, we can use UiPath. So let's UiPath Orchestrator. Let's run it from Orchestrator. Let's click Start. Right now, it should send command from UiPath Orchestrator to our computer. And here we see that something is happening. And one second. And here we see this window. So command using REST API was sent from UiPath Orchestrator to our UiPath Assistant on our computer. And this robot was successfully run. Let's click OK. And now we can open UiPath Assistant and we see that we have this robot. And also we can run it from UiPath Assistant. Let's click Start. And the same window. It's what we expected. Also we can open robots in Orchestrator. We see that we have this robot, type unattended, status available. Also we have jobs history, what was executed. So right now we have two entries. The first one was executed from Orchestrator, the second one we executed directly from UiPath Assistant. And now for demo, let's close Orchestrator. We don't need it anymore. Let's close UiPath Studio. We don't need it. And let's close everything else. So we have UiPath Assistant. Assistant is a tool which helps us to manage all robots we have on our computer. It's connected to UiPath Robot. Robot is a service which runs all robots on your computer. Names are the same, but UiPath Robot. Okay. And now as well we can run, we can add some reminders. We can check all running processes. If we click this one, we see that this process is running. And now, as you see, we can run this robot even without UiPath Studio or without UiPath Orchestrator. So if you are interested in learning more about UiPath Studio, I would recommend you to check description. There is a link to my course where I describe how to use UiPath, its introduction to UiPath and introduction to robot process automation in general. And also you can get even more videos on my YouTube channel, so don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube. And if you have any questions, so leave a comment, I will try to answer all your questions. So thank you for watching and soon there will be more interesting videos.